Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Before I begin my remarks on the amazing saint that is the Forerunner, John the Baptist, it would seem that the Forerunner has a special place in his heart for the parish of St. Basil here on Ashland Avenue. Inasmuch as our Sunday chanter is John Lambros, a student chanter who serves with us many times is John Stathopoulos, and a chanter who serves perhaps more liturgies than anyone else for our parish is John Kalesh. All who look to the Forerunner as their patron. And we are extremely blessed and extremely, extremely blessed to have John chant with us this morning on his feast day, Cronio Pola. St. John the Baptist in today's gospel passage said, "Behold, he who is coming after me is greater than me because he was before me." He makes special mention in the gospel according to St. John to say that he did not know who Jesus Christ was, that he was looking for certain signs that were revealed to him by the Father, that the one upon whom the dove descends and remains, this is the Christ. Our Forerunner, we do know, knew Jesus Christ before this amazing moment in history. And that, of course, was when he was still in his mother Elizabeth's womb, when the Virgin Mary came after she had been conceived of the Holy Spirit, and John leapt in the womb of Elizabeth, because even though with his physical eyes he could not see Jesus Christ, he saw that this person was God, and he rejoiced exceedingly. Jesus Christ tells us that under heaven, no one was greater than John the Baptist, that this man is the pinnacle of sanctity, a prophet in every sense of the word. The moniker given to St. John was, "Behold, the voice of one crying in the wilderness." For you see, John's message came from outside and penetrated inside. His message was not yelled in the city streets of Jerusalem, but outside at the River Jordan, where people came to be healed of their spiritual maladies, because he offered them something, the baptism of repentance, the baptism of water in which sins are washed clean. And that's part of our journey. But John the Baptist tells us that he who comes after me is greater than me because he is before me. Because even though Jesus Christ is technically 6 months younger than John the Baptist, of course he's before John the Baptist, as he is the Christ before all time. But John is talking about our Lord's baptism, the baptism of the Holy Spirit, which transforms us mystically into new beings, a new creation. The baptism of repentance is quintessential for us to receive that Holy Spirit. After all, if we are full of ourselves, there is no room for the Holy Spirit. John the Baptist, crying out in the wilderness, makes straight the path of the Lord by talking to us, guiding us, exhorting us to empty ourselves, to repent, so that we can receive the Holy Spirit. It is my hope that all of us will turn to the Forerunner daily and ask for his guidance on how we too can live angelic lives and go straight to our Lord, so that his voice is not one in the wilderness, far off, but is echoing loudly in our minds, in our hearts, and in our souls.